Now, ladies and gentlemen, here's one you all can sing with us when the saints go marching in.
Okay, so I went to New Orleans with a chip on my shoulder. From what I knew about this city, it was full of inebriated college students and plastic bead necklaces thrown from balconies. Not necessarily my kind of scene. So spending money to stay, eat, and travel there for a bachelorette party was kind of the last thing I wanted to do. But I loved my brother's fiance, so I was gonna do it anyway. I'll be the first to admit, however, that I was embarrassingly wrong. Sure, New Orleans has several inebriated college students, and I did get hit with a brightly colored green beaded necklace along Bourbon Street. But there was so much more to the city that I never knew. Amid the grime, faded colors, and dulled stones, walked artists and tourists, the poor, the rich, the foreign and the native, the religious and the disillusioned, the infatuated and the heartbroken. Everyone came together to experience what the city offered. An overwhelming, almost choking sensation of both the vibrancy and dearth of life itself. You want to see that? You have to go to Jackson Square.
Bonjour mesdames, bonjour mesdemoiselles, bonjour messieurs.
This sensation of what New Orleans really is, for me, was most apparent in the architecture of the French Quarter, where 18th and 19th century designs embellished 21st century lives. I couldn't help but strain my neck upwards towards the ornate balconies and turn my head left to right emphatically so I could capture each of the pastel-painted doors I passed. Each one opened up to a domestically modern world that inhabited a historically preserved home that had survived all life had thrown at it, including, remarkably, Hurricane Katrina.
And a water fuel coming up, the car's afloat. What do you do? Pray to God and you can make it through. That's all you can do.
Governor Blanco and I, Mayor C. Ray Nagin, have each declared a state of emergency.
This is the story of New Orleans. This is the story that should be told. It's so much more than the bars along Bourbon or Mardi Gras. It's a city of resilience, a city that through its architecture evokes a feeling of nostalgia for past moments you never experienced. It transports you to whatever version of history comforts your soul and feeds your imagination. New Orleans is the epitome of magic.